So MSNBC did a segment explaining democratic socialism, and there's actually quite a bit to say about this. There are upsides of this and there are downsides of this. So let's take a look at that, and then I'll come back and explain.
With Alexandria Ocasio-Cortez's primary win Tuesday night here in New York, the term democratic socialism was the most searched term on Merriam-Webster's website. So what are we talking about here? The word most people focus on is socialism. But while democratic socialists pull some ideas from that ideology, they are not traditional socialists. There is no call for communal ownership of production. Here's what else it is not. Communism. Most people use communism and socialism interchangeably, even Karl Marx. But communism is a political ideology, while socialism centers more on economics. They're related, but none of this has to do with democratic socialists. What they do call for is the enactment of certain socialist ideas through the democratic process, meaning everyone has a vote on whether they are a good idea or not. In many countries, democratic socialists work alongside other parties in broad coalitions. Their goal is to control prices of essential services like medicine, banking regulations, affordable education, and the ability to work. All sounds reasonable. All of that is in the effort to minimize economic inequality and allow everyone in society to not just survive, but have the ability to thrive and enjoy life, a concept they call bread and roses. And if you think some of these ideas are too alien to American culture, take a look at this. Social Security is a pension system run by the government. Medicaid and Medicare are government-run medical services. Even Amtrak is a government-owned transportation system. All of these are hallmarks of democratic socialist policy.
Right.
So, yes and no. First, let's discuss the no part. Technically, they're wrong. And it's not just them, it's pretty much everybody that's somewhat in the mainstream. And as far as I can tell, this actually started with Bernie Sanders. So Bernie Sanders described himself as a democratic socialist. Obviously, this became big news in 2015, 2016, around there in the Democratic primary. And, you know, Bernie Sanders describes his democratic socialism in a similar way as MSNBC just defined it. Now, here's the problem. If you want to be really technical and really literal here, they're wrong. Bernie Sanders is wrong. You know, again, MSNBC just described it this way. I heard on TYT they described it this way, among many other places. You know, they're describing it in a way that if you go to the textbook definitions, they are just factually incorrect. So, democratic socialism, in reality, actually is post-capitalist. It's a post-capitalism philosophy. So in other words, it doesn't coexist with capitalism. It's not a mixed market economy. It is post-capitalist. So what that means is social ownership of the means of production. But what you see here is they're not describing that. They're not describing a post-capitalist philosophy. They're describing a system that coincides with capitalism. So what they're defining, and when I say they, I mean MSNBC in this clip, Bernie Sanders, and many others, what they're really describing is social democracy. So social democracy is a heavily regulated version of capitalism. It's a mixed market economy, and it has strong socialist aspects in there. So another way to talk about social democracy is welfare statism. Now, I'm not saying that word as a pejorative. Nowadays, the term, you know, welfare is used as with a negative connotation. I don't mean it that way at all. In fact, I quite openly support welfare statism. And so the idea is, yes, you have a capitalist economy, but you have socialist institutions mixed in there as well. Healthcare, education, you know, you can have universal daycare. And you take some aspects of capitalism and mix it with some aspects of socialism, and you try to get the best of both worlds. And another way to describe this is the Scandinavian model. Social democracy is the Scandinavian model. And it's also what I describe as the furthest left you can go within the context of capitalism. It's that last stop on the capitalist train station to the left. So that's what they're describing on MSNBC. Bernie Sanders, even though he describes himself as a democratic socialist, he's actually a social democrat. And I remember doing segments back in 2015 where I implored Bernie Sanders to describe himself as a social democrat, a believer in social democracy, and not a democratic socialist, because I just, for accuracy's sake, because I'm a literal-minded type person, I was just thinking, I don't know why he's incorrectly explaining his beliefs. But here's the thing, man, and I take no pleasure in saying this, I think we're now too far gone. In the sense that now the term democratic socialist is being used interchangeably with social democracy. I don't think there's any putting the cat back in that bag. I don't think it's going to happen. And I think that we lost that once Bernie Sanders described himself as a democratic socialist, even though he's a social democrat. So now, you know, and I imagine that the people who are most annoyed by this are actual democratic socialists. Because a real democratic socialist would watch this clip where they're describing social democracy and calling it democratic socialism. They would watch this clip from MSNBC and just be like, no, you're just fucking wrong and fuck you, because you're watering down their post-capitalist ideology. But in my mind, that's a losing battle, and I'm not willing to fight that battle anymore. So, and I fought it for a long time. So what I do now is I just use it interchangeably. And when I talk about democratic socialism, I mean both democratic socialism, the post-capitalist philosophy, but also social democracy. So in a weird way, there's like a moderate slash centrist version of democratic socialism, which is social democracy. And then there's the actual left version of democratic socialism, which is post-capitalist. And I don't think, again, I don't think there's any winning that battle. As soon as Bernie Sanders spoke about democratic socialism, but described social democracy, that's it. Now the definition's kind of changed. And now Alexandria Ocasio-Cortez has been describing herself as a democratic socialist, but again, she's more of a social democrat. And MSNBC is defining democratic socialism as social democracy. And I get it, man. All you political junkies out there look at that and it annoys the shit out of you. And believe me, it annoyed the shit out of me for a really long time, too. But you just got to understand that, unfortunately, the reality is that definitions change. Political definitions change. Libertarian, the term libertarian, in a European context, when you go back in history, that was used to describe a variety of socialism. In the U.S., libertarianism, as you guys know, is used to describe a kind of anarcho-capitalism, a right-wing market philosophy. So, I mean, this is just par for the course, man. We've seen it happen with classical liberal. You know, classical liberal now seems to have two meanings. One of them is just, you know, libertarian, which is the old school textbook definition. The other meaning classical liberal has come to take is, you know, kind of like a center-left, almost neoliberal type philosophy. And all you can do is just try to be accurate in terms of what you believe. You know, so the devil's always in the details, and the labels were always somewhat misleading anyway. You know, I've often told the story of during the 2016 primary, Bernie Sanders just crushed Hillary Clinton in the Midwest. Now, these are more conservative states overall, and Bernie won among self-described conservatives in these races in the Democratic primary. Like, okay, I'm a conservative Democrat. Now, how can that be? Hillary Clinton is literally more conservative than Bernie Sanders. That's not a matter of opinion. That's not conjecture. That's fact. She is more right-wing than Bernie Sanders. It is what it is. But again, the point there is people don't really know about labels. They just hear Bernie talk and they go, I like what that guy's advocating for. Even though they describe themselves as more conservative, they went with Bernie Sanders over Hillary, who's more to the left. So that just goes to show you people's ideas and perceptions of what labels are and what they entail. It doesn't mean anything. You know, when you ask the American people, hey, where do you fall on the political spectrum? Most say I'm center-right. They think they're moderately conservative. But when you actually go issue for issue through their policy beliefs, they describe a populist left philosophy, a libertarian left-wing philosophy. So again, that just shows people don't really know about labels. And unfortunately, the state of the world we live in is fucking people who are supposed to be political journalists, like the people at MSNBC, they don't know the labels. And neither did fucking Bernie Sanders, man. Bernie Sanders is a run-of-the-mill social democrat, but he describes, he says, I'm a democratic socialist. Now, the only thing I could think is maybe Bernie is a democratic socialist, but he just doesn't, he conceals the fact that he believes in a post-capitalist system. But I don't think that's true because he's the most honest guy in the country, and he's never said, I believe in post-capitalism, and everything he describes is a social democratic belief. So, I just think he incorrectly stated what he believes, and now we're too far gone, and everybody's describing social democracy as democratic socialism. So democratic socialism now, like it or not, has two meanings. And one of them is actual democratic socialism, and the other one is social democracy. Now, That's the portion of this that, remember at the beginning I said, so yes and no to this clip? That's the no part. Here's the yes part. What they're describing is overwhelmingly popular. Like, social democratic positions have such a broad appeal that you get, the left will line up behind them in the U.S., because they already do. But even the right lines up behind these ideas, man. If you talk to the right about post-capitalist ideas, they'll shut down and say, nope, not even interested. But if you talk to the right about social democratic ideas, they're already on board. There are more Republicans that support Medicare for All than don't right now. And that's just one example. We can go on and on. Whether, you know, when it, higher taxes on the rich, more Republicans actually support that than don't. Legalizing marijuana at this point. So many of the social democratic ideas, they just cut across party lines. And so what they're describing as democratic socialism on MSNBC is something that even the right can get behind. So that's the good part of this, is that there's a mainstreaming of these left-wing ideas in society right now. And that's happened with Bernie describing himself as that, with Alexandria Ocasio-Cortez describing herself as that. And I think there's nothing but upsides there. Overall, even though we've now muddled some definitions and kind of evolved on some definitions, I still think this is a good thing because now you're seeing these ideas become very mainstream, and that's not something we saw even 5 years ago. So, I think the left revolution will continue, and I think that will improve many people's lives the more we mainstream these ideas, because then these ideas will grow more and more popular, even though they're already popular, and eventually we'll hit a tipping point, and we'll get that exact kind of revolution that we're looking for. I mean, we just spoke about how in Mexico, the populist left anti-corruption candidate won the presidential election. I think TikTok for us. Alexandria Ocasio-Cortez was just the shot across the bow, and a lot more is going to happen.